92. We welcome you back to the Two Guys Named Chris show. We're without Dave Aiken today. BB Shea is filling in, of course. We have had a story earlier in the week. Here's a quick email follow-up. A few emails here in this segment. Big Red says, now this was about the study showing that single men especially have a lot of fecal matter on their coffee tables because they put their shoes, their feet up on the coffee table with shoes on. Do you do that, Nicholas?
No.
You're a single man, but you look at your parents. Yes. Did you when you had your...
I put my feet up on the couch.
What about when you had your own place?
Yeah, all the time. Yeah.
Shoes on?
Shoes on the coffee table, yeah.
Well, unfortunately, you had fecal matter on the coffee table.
Thanks. I had no idea.
It's dog. A lot of times.
Literally.
Well, sometimes you're in the bathroom, you have urine too, on the bottom of the shoes. Bottom of the shoes. Very nasty place.
That's why I think there should be a sanitizer. Just a step through sanitizer for shoes.
Thanks, Mark. I mean, if that could be done.
Shark Tank that.
If you either leave them, his idea was you either leave them there when you come in your house, or just step through them when you go into a place for 30 seconds, and they laser clean your shoes as you go in. That's a good idea. Big Red says, in college, one of my roommates got rip-roaring drunk, came in very late at night, and mistook our coffee table for the toilet. Got butt naked, sat down, dropped a deuce right in the middle of the coffee table.
Bruh. Come on, man.
Crawled over, passed out on the couch. That's how we found him the next morning.
Bruh.
He woke up and was shocked. See what he had done.
What am I doing?
It's a real wake-up call, there, don't you think?
I feel like it is.
The light bulb moment.
I mean, did he not think, where's the flusher?
I don't think he cared.
Where's the hand?
He must have been. He dropped. Big Red said he was so drunk that he dropped a deuce in the middle. So they woke up and found him naked on the couch with a coffee table with that sitting on top.
I did something similar. I threw up on the oven one time when I was in school, and then I tried to clean it up, but then a month later we heated it up, and there was still remnants in the grates. And then they just smelled terrible for like a month. So I was vomiting into the sink, but it was on top of the stove.
God, that may be worse.
So, yeah, I know where this guy's coming from. I've been there.
Well, I say it may be worse because when you turn on the oven later, that's the double whammy.
Jeez.
Yeah. But bully for you for trying to clean it up.
I tried my best. Yeah, it just didn't work out that way.
The next morning you tried to do the cleanup?
No, I was drunk when I tried to do the cleanup.
Oh, okay.
I woke up the next morning and left and forgot that it happened, and then it wasn't until later. I'm like, oh, yeah, that's why it smells.
Here.
So,
What?
Oh,
beer, yeah.
Dang, what is the
smell? Dang, man.
Reheating oak.
Worst.
You can find that recipe on our website. At twoguysandchris.com. That's BB Shea's contribution.
It's a BB Shea special.
Dang.
What did you eat when you were drunk?
Oh, dude.
It was
a bunch of like Jimmy Dean croissants and Pop Tarts and stuff. Yeah.
Man. Your diet is frozen
egg.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. No.
Yeah. You know when you get late night drunk?
Jimmy Dean. You notice Jimmy Dean's been dead for about 25 years. He's still doing work. Chris Tim always applauds that because he's still getting steady work.
Yeah. Other than Bob Marley and Elvis, he gets more work from almost Jimmy Dean.
With AI, I bet they can make him say new stuff. At least very
true.
Soon.
Yeah.
Don't you think? Soon they can make him say new stuff. Well, Big Red says after he passed it, the next morning we woke him up and said, bruh, look what you did. And he said, I'm buying you a new coffee table. And he did. He bought a new coffee table. So good for him.
I think it's only fair.
Buying the new coffee table and cleaning up the man's butt. My, you think I pictured him getting on top of the coffee table, but I guess he stood next to it and just crap. But he's, did you sit on it?
He had to just sat on it.
But then, there's no hole.
I know.
There's no hole in a coffee table. I don't believe. Unless it's some sort of special type thing.
Is it worse glass top or wooden?
I thought a lot about that. I think it's worse wooden top. I think glass
too.
True.
My immediate thought was glass. You can wipe off and get it.
Bleach it.
Wood. It's just kind of like.
It's in the
you know it's
in the gray. God, it's terrible. It's at the stove.
That's we had a weird spot on your coffee table.
Is that a cigarette burn? I wish.
It's a special tiki wood. How did you
clean it up later, though. I mean, later you had to just get rid of that smell. You go wet shit with that.
No, so I threw up and I was drunk and I got paper towels and cleaned it. And it looked fine. I just used paper towels. But it got in the grate.
Great.
And so I didn't see it because I thought I cleaned it well.
But after you cooked, did you go back and try to clean even more?
Oh, no, I figured it just cooked it all out. Yeah.
Oh,
that is awful.
That is awful.
You easy off that thing?
No.
Yeah, you should. That's
I'm just trying to go back to sleep.
Yeah. Easy off really works. Yeah. You ever tried that?
Oh, yeah.
That stuff really works. We used to have it when I was really young, even younger. Then recently we cleaned the oven with Easy Off. That's it. I don't know what's in it, but it was awful stuff on your stove. There is a woman in Virginia. Now, this is Father's Day weekend here, and we've talked about this a few times before. She had a surprise baby, and the dad was with her ordering at Taco Bell. She didn't know she was pregnant. It's Tamarez and Brioni Jackson. Birth of their daughter happened 2 days ago in Virginia. The mom went to the bathroom.
Toilet baby.
Has a baby. She was shot.
We had last week was Golden Corral.
That's right. And the baby's name was...
The middle name was Corral.
Was Corral. This baby's middle name is Taco. Because of Taco Bell. These are the parents.
I'm running past another bread, and then I hear her just let out this gut-wrenching scream. I'm still panicking. I'm like, babe, say something. And then she's like, oh my God, I just had a baby.
So I was like, okay, no, there's no way. I picked her up. I wrapped her in my shirt. She hadn't let out a cry or anything yet. Boy or girl? Look, it's a girl. Hang up and call 911. And next thing I know, I was hearing a dad's
and she gave birth, and they ducked into the Taco Bell to give birth. Because she said, I'm having terrible pains.
Not terrible.
This is terrible. Too expensive.
This is terrible.
Yeah.
How I feel about Panera.
I've heard your comments.
Growing up, though, for the rest of your life, you will be known as the Taco Bell baby.
Yeah.
And I would much rather, frankly, be known as the Panera
baby.
100%.
Classier.
100%. Yeah.
As you say, it's like, where are you born? I was born at a Taco Bell.
You say Panera.
You say Panera, people go, oh, what's the story?
Oh, yeah.
You're right.
Yeah, it's a
different
difference in perception of the two restaurants, Taco Bell versus Panera.
Oh, man, from your parents.
Right.
Oh, was your mother in there doing some online work?
Yeah,
way different.
Totally. You're exactly right. Are you with your photo of Panera?
I love Panera.
You do love Panera?
Yes.
He says it's
a lot.
I'll tell you, I'm not a Panera fan either. I'm not a Panera fan. No, I think it's overpriced and that it's got a lot of... I don't like the bagels.
Well, nobody likes the bagels.
They're too bready.
I love the bagels.
We love the
cinnamon crunch bagel? Yeah, man.
I do not like that bagel.
That's breakfast cereal.
I do not like that bagel.
The bagel's supposed to be disappointing when you eat it.
Yes. Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
See, he loves anything that is like a combo of cereal. I've eaten enough meals with this man. We've done 200 episodes of eating together.
That's right. That's right. And so you like that kind of thing. Here's the controversy. Teen boys are being told by TikTok doc, don't do this. There's a product out there that is a gum. It's called Rock Jaw. And kids are teenagers, especially, for chewing it because they think it'll give them a more chiseled jaw. So that's apparently it spread on TikTok and Reddit among men, and especially boys. It's called a mastic gum, sold by vendors called Rock Jaw, Stronger Gum, and Jawliner, and it promises a chiseled jawline, building jaw muscles, and improving definition in the face. Doctors say it doesn't work because there's no point in doing it. I guess it's harder to chew than regular chewing gum.
Yeah,
it's thicker. I just looked it up. It's thicker. It was invented 4 years ago.
Mm-hmm. A thicker gum?
It's 10 to 14 times stronger than regular
gum. Mm-hmm.
1,000% results or your money back.
I don't know that. Well, actually, when I read it, I was like, I might want to try to do it.
It's made out of mastic.
That's what it says here, mastic. Mastic gum. What is that? That product, man?
I don't know if it's a mineral or harvested in the island of Chios in Greece.
One doctor says even if it does enhance the appearance of the jawline, it could lead to overgrown jaw muscles and issues with your jaw, like popping, clicking, or TMJ. Is that lockjaw, TMJ?
No, that's something else.
TMJ. That's where you, it's like out of line or something, right? So he says don't don't do it. It probably won't sharpen the undersurface of the jawline if your bone structure is not there already.
Did the grown-ups do it?
The point in doing it.
It's not the teen.
Yeah, he just said it didn't work for anybody. And even if it does, it can cause you all those issues I just mentioned.
I want to try it.
I do too.
I
give me
I'm interested in
the
jowl area.
I'm a little jowly. I have some issues right here.
Okay.
Admitted last week to doing my exercises where I pat in the side of the jawline
while you're sitting on the toilet.
Is that supposed to help? My mother would often walk around the house doing this, like just slapping it underneath the bottom of her chin. Yeah, to get rid of those little excess down there, you know. So I would certainly try something like that, but now I'm reading you shouldn't do it, especially teen boys don't do it. But that's the ones that are most interesting.
Yeah.
So there's a
tons of products out there made of plastic. It's from a tree in Greece.
I've never heard that word.
It's the resin,
yeah.
A sap, if you will, I guess, from the mastic tree.
Does it say what it costs for a pack of
jawbreaker or whatever? Ooh, mastic gum for jawline. Number one, gum of the gods. Premium pack, $75. Here's one. $15 Amazon. $20.
See, but if I ordered that, my wife would be mad. Because I tried the.
Yeah,
you know, I got that. I got those pounded powdery vegetables.
Okay, what was it called?
AG1. I did a.
Did you ever sell that off?
It's still in my fridge. I offered, but we have a salesperson here who offered to buy it for like $30.
I tried to take it for
I said yes, but it never came again. I never brought it in. The VC one there. You mix AG1, it's a powdered green, it's a powdered vegetable, and pulverized, and you mix it together. You want it, maybe you should tweet it out.
If you want to go half in on some rock jaw, I can order a seat at my house. Now your wife doesn't know about it. Maybe you just chew it here.
You bring me a stick of gum every day?
Absolutely.
And we make the deal in the park. You just slide it to me and hand it to me in the park.
Did you spend with me a few dollars?
She sees my Venmo.
Oh, dang,
you're
lying.
You know what? The actual packets of rock jaw, it's on clearance right now. 10 packs, $1.99.
Oh, this is
well,
steal.
Well, I know. Okay.
She sees my Venmo.
She does. She has access to all my Venmos and PayPal and Venmo.
I saw somebody say the other day, Venmo is their new favorite social media site. Like watching couples pay each other for coffee.
Yeah.
If you're married, bro, quit charging your wife for a month.
I don't understand the world. Well, Venmo, you see what people, if you want, you can see what people spend. Like, you can even look at somebody else's account.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
And see what they spend.
Yeah, you gotta set it to private. All your Venmos are out there.
I know, I don't understand. Like, it says pizza or whatever, you know, so you can, you literally, like, if I'm Venmoing somebody, I can see the last pin thing or whatever I spent money on. That's very strange. This is about a teenager also. A P1 listener says, my son is 13. He's on a football team. They're doing a car wash fundraiser in the near future. My son wants to go, but I'm not supporting it because it's being hosted in the parking lot of a marijuana shop. We live in a state where weed is legal, but it's highly inappropriate in my opinion. Am I the only reasonable person out there to feel so strongly against this? I will not allow my son to participate. I messaged the coach and he said, it's an optional event, but nobody's had a problem with it so far. So the car wash is in a marijuana dispensary. And the kids are 13 years old.
It is a bad option.
It's a terrible deal. It's a terrible deal.
We used to, I remember when the teenagers at our high school.
Yes.
They did it on the school ground.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, they just did it in the bus lot.
I wonder if this is not a school team. She says he's on a football team, but she didn't say for the school. And he's 13. Yeah.
Any other sponsor out there?
Can no one, I mean, the marijuana dispensary is the only place. I don't really blame her for being mad. I mean, it is a bad deal. You know, you got a bunch of 13-year-olds in front of a dispensary. And to call me old-fashioned. But that's a bad. And, you know, I support legalization.
He does.
You know that.
Yeah. Is it in gum form yet? Is there weed gum?
Could we combine the weed gum with the jaw?
Strong jawline.
Yeah. You're high, but your jaw has never looked better. Fantastic. But you all won't know it. You barely look in the mirror. I don't know. I just somebody just sent me some of those drinks too that are I forget the name of them. We talked about trying them.
Oh yeah, all the seltzers.
Yeah, I have four. They've got weed infused.
Yeah. You can call it ganja gum.
Ganja gum.
Ganja gum.
For the jaw.
Yes.
Well, anyway, I'm with the parent. I think I would probably say don't do it. Coming up here on the Two Guys and Chris Show. This is football. Cleveland Browns football legend, Amadara. Would you believe sports betting? Very unusual story is coming up next in a different bullet from the Two Guys and Chris Show.
June 13th through 23rd, featuring rides for all ages, games, a petting zoo, and food of all kinds. Admission $5 at the gate. Kids 12 and under, free. Weekdays 5 to 10, weekends 2 to 10, in the LJVM Coliseum parking lot.
You've got lots of home projects to tackle.
See the new guy, the Iron Police?
Yeah.
You see the new car the Iron Police got? I don't know what the hell to do with a lot of fucking police cars. They got a lot of police cars. They're spending taxes on the people around here.